Welcome to FX Bootcamp London. My name is Christian Stevens. Today is Friday, August 28th, 2009. This is your daily London session video, a review of a little bit of what we did today in the live London session class at fxbootcamp.com. Let me first remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. We are not an alert service. Myself nor any of the other currency coaches will make any trade recommendations during the course of a day. Please be mindful that trading under leverage is always risky business. Occasionally, as a novice trader, using excessive leverage will work for you. And fortunately, more times than not, it will work against you. So please do not trade real money in Forex until you have a proven track record of success on a free demonstration account. One more thing before we get started, whether you're watching this video on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, or our blog at FX Street, I'd like to ask if you could please leave a comment when you're done watching this video, even if it's a short one, just a hello, a thanks, appreciate the feedback or any kind of criticism, whatever. We very much appreciate your feedback. Well, today we open up the London session already in profit on some decent British pound longs. Now, I say British pound and not a currency after it because really it didn't matter what you took. We had every reason in the world to have entries on euro pound, pound Swissie, pound dollar, pound yen. I'm going to show you what really brought my focus to this to begin with. I'm going to pull up a two-hour euro pound. Now, I'm not going to go over the initial entries because they happened in pre-London, but I will go over continuation entries that happened in our session live that we covered in class for reloads, or if you missed the first chance opportunity in the London session. I'm going back here. This is what we were staring at the London Open, prior to London Open. You can see how the MACD histogram has been heading down here. Okay, for quite a while now. All these lower peaks, even on stochastics, but price continues to go up. This is the euro pound 2 hour chart, and that's fine. And we've been longing all day long. But you're noticing that this MACD is threatening across. And if you pull this down a little bit, this is indicating something's lying for direction. Okay, and lo and behold, right here at the beginning of pre-London, you get yourself a lower peak. Guys, that's a lower high. So for the first time, you've got a lower high threatening a second MACD cross, which is usually the most powerful one after MACD and stochastic divergence well extended on euro pound. Okay, now that's how we use that for pound strength to get into the to begin with in pre-London, and we were at least planning to take this to the 2 hour 21. Possibly further in the long term. We're getting a continuation move right now in the pound. Actually, the dollar's waking up while I'm making the video. But let me just show you a four-hour chart of that same euro pound to give you an idea of how long of an uptrend we've been on this euro pound. It's a pretty good rise. A little bit of divergence here, too. A little stochastic divergence on the four-hour. It seems very feasible for us to head down to the 21 EMA or possibly even overshoot it a little bit down to this area, at least before possibly pulling back to the five. And we'll see if we're going to continue or what. All right, so that out of the way, that was the basis for it. Now, euro pound yen, you could have seen the same thing in the opposite, I'm sorry, pound Swissie, the same thing in the opposite direction. I just wanted to give you the reason we were even looking at it to begin with. Now, I'm going to zoom into pound yen. We had trades all night on literally euro pound, pound dollar, pound Swissie, and pound yen. I'm going to talk about the pound yen. It offered, I think, one of the better reload opportunities of the pounds earlier in the session, okay? This is about between 1 and 2 in the morning New York time, and you can see the higher low down here during that portion of the session. You might have had a trap, right here in pre-London. And been able to snatch a long, see how you have a double bottom followed by a higher low. That's a very nice approach to continue entering there pre-London. And we took it up to 53.05, okay, which is up in this area where we had resistance before. We'll call it the psych level, all right? And this is right at the London Open. As I take the mic at 3 a.m., we're pulling back from that 53.26 zone, all right? And, a lot of us had taken that long either right here, or as you can see, this is a fib pullback to the 21 up to this level or this level. Now, what I want to talk about is you're coming into London Open and we're not quite at resistance. I'm going to pull over a 2 hour pound yen chart for a moment and show you what was right at 53.26 where we wicked at right at pre-London. See this trend line going back, connect these tops at 53.26? That's exactly where we bounced off of at pre-London. So it's very feasible when that sort of thing happens. Let me zoom in. All right, that we hit resistance, that even if we're going to break it, it's very likely that you're going to pull back to an area of support, and that's where you're going to look for clues for continuation. Remember, we're bullish on the pound to begin with based on, oh, sweet, there it goes, based on the euro pound I told you to begin with, and now we're breaking the trend line in the London lunch. So that was the, you know, that trend line I'm showing you is exactly where we found ourselves bouncing just before London open. Okay, I mean, that's right at that trend line at, I think it was 7 and a half. Yeah, okay. Now, as far as target is concerned, one more thing, let me show you. The 382 Fib and the 4-hour 21 EMA are also right in that 20 area. I'm in a trade right now following this. We're back up at M4. Let me move a stop one sec. Sorry about that. I had to adjust the profit stop there. So, you know, we have that trend line. We have the 382 Fib. Let me actually zoom into this a little bit more. Okay, and exactly that bounce I'm telling you about is happening right off of this Fib. And right off that 21, right off that trend line I told you coming down, that, you know, was a reasonable place for some people to take a chance of a short. But, you know, considering what we're showing you on the euro pound and the pound Swissy, we're looking for a continuation here. So naturally, what we want to do, since we've hit resistance, is grab the top of this and draw a Fib study to the absolute bottom of the entire move. And this double bottom would be the bottom of the move. So what we're looking for is a retracement to somewhere in this vicinity. Now, I highlight this entire region because you've got the 5 EMA, the 50% Fib. You also have a 200 EMA and the 21 EMA. No way in the world do you want to see it break below this 21 EMA or 50 or something like that. You also, if you look over at the hourly here, have an hourly 5 EMA at this point. This is that high at 26. So anywhere around here, if we could see some short-term confirmation, could be a reasonable entry zone to take us at least to M4, if not to the 53.50 area, and if we really get lucky, 5,400. Now, this is a daily chart of pound yen, all right? And I want to show you how you have a situation here where you have a previous swing low respected several times over, okay? Even back here, you had wicks past it, but no basis of a candle. Guys, this was our area of possible roll reversal, and if we break this, we could be in for at least, you know, up to a decent rise to that daily 21. If you fib this swing here, this entire daily swing, you'll see that is the 382. Now, obviously, we're sitting there right now, but we weren't quite there yet coming into the London session, right? We stopped short. So that was our next target. In other words, we're trying to look for a long around that 5360 or 70 area, 5260 or 70 area to get to 5350. That was the trade plan on the pound yen. Anyway, here we are on a 15-minute candle. You can see it comes down around the 70 area. You get a little green, and she's gone. Now, you know, if you're just watching a 15-minute chart, you're probably not in this trade unless you took it speculatively right off the 618 Fib, which we hit to the pip at 67. You might even be in at 80. But this is how we entered it. We used a short-term chart at this point when we're getting down to that zone. Let me draw that same Fib. This is a one-minute chart from the top to the bottom, just like on the other one. And this is how you can use a short-term time frame to give you a little bit of a warm and fuzzy feeling. One more thing. Actually, this blue line, let me get rid of the Fib for a sec. This blue line coming down is just connecting these two tops. And ironically, that's right where we found our 618, and we were starting to show some level of support. Right, look at the bottom here, this 3 a.m. time. This is the London Open. This is 8 a.m. London. The London money is now sitting down ready to go to work, and they're seeing strength on the British pound and at support. What do you think London's going to want to do there? Long, right? Not you want to short at support necessarily. I mean, if this is going to fail in reverse, you're going to expect the bounce from here, maybe a reverse Fib here, and then that kind of thing. Certainly enough pips in there to lock in break even. That's the trade plan. So let's zoom into the actual entry criteria. Okay, and you'll find that we hit the 618 Fib. All right, we bounce a little bit. Now, an aggressive trader could have taken this. Remember, going back to the 15 real quick, any entry around this zone is fine. Your stop is probably in the mid-55s, and if you really want to give it the best stop in the world, below this swing low, which puts you below the 786, maybe at 152.48, which is where my stop was. Okay, let's get back to this. I didn't take it right away. I was in a basket today. I was in a lot of the pound pairs. So I watched this behavior because, you know, we're getting a steady series of lower highs here. You know, and we hit the support. We bounce off of it a little bit. And, you know, the first place that logically makes sense to take an entry is probably right here, because you get a little bit of green right off, you know, a little bit of a higher low. Or if you didn't take that, you notice that we get another lower high. We come back down double bottom. So we're now double bottom at the 618 Fib. Nice. Alarm just went off. Sorry about that. And that's a euro pound alarm, so it's got a lower low. You know, any long in here around 70 was fantastic. Again, about a 22 pip stop or at this screen right here. And that's it. That's the end of it. Now you find yourself, let me do this little fib here. The other way, right in a 618 fib zone, you're at 5,300. You find yourself approximately 30 pips in profit. No more reason to take a risk. Move that stop up to break even, hands off, and you're hoping for continuation. And it comes down, almost stops out, not quite, continues and shoots up. All right, and that's really, if I zoom out this entire 15-minute chart, okay, you could see the high here at the fib. You could see the this is the fib entry zone we just highlighted on the 1 minute. Let me and now we just hit a we've just done a 618 to a 1382 fib extension right now. And if I look over at this hourly pivot point, here we are at the beginning of New York Open, second test of the M4 reversal pivot point. Now we've hit the fib extension off of this. We performed the entire move. Now I'm not going to kid you here. There was news at 4:30 right here. Okay. So the idea when we hit 153.40, you know, just before news, I'm sorry, 153.50, just before news, you know, right in that zone, that was a good place to take profit or partial profit, close enough to our target. And again, there was another opportunity to get long if you fib it like this as well on 3:21 EMA continuation right off of 53. Right after that news for another 60 pips. So, you know, there were quite a few trade plans today on the British pound. I don't know that we're necessarily done, but this was a fantastic day for the British pound. I mean, if you took all these like a basket all over the place like I did, you cleaned up. I mean, it was a cleanup day, and the pound dollar is just is launching as well fantastically. Let me scoot over to pound dollar here. Pound Swissy was as well until the Swissy intervened. And now, you know, we find ourselves a pound dollar up at the next area of resistance right at New York Open pretty much. This is our next area of resistance. We broke the 382 daily 20 or 4 hour 21. And, you know, the 6380 area is looking pretty interesting for resistance. So anyway, that was just one of the trade plans we did today at FXBootcamp.com. If you'd like to learn how to do one of these trade plans on your own on a regular basis, please come visit us in class. We'd love to have you there. You guys have a fantastic weekend. Cheers.